I have a table in Excel with information about cookies, and it also includes images of all of those cookies. In the past, when I inserted an image into Excel, it would just float above the worksheet. But now I can embed those images directly into the cells. The benefit is, let's say I want to filter or sort my data, let's say from maybe most popular to least popular cookie, it'll sort all of those images too. We really need to work on that fortune cookie recipe. Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we're going to learn how to insert images directly into cells in Excel. It's really easy, so let's check this out. Here in Excel, I am missing an image for the oatmeal raisin cookie, a classic. I want to insert an image into this cell. I'll select this cell, and then up above on the ribbon, let's click on the insert function icon. This opens up the insert function dialog, and here let's search for the new image function. I'll type in image, click on go, and then let's select this function right here. This opens up the function arguments, and there's only one required argument. How do I know that? Well, this one's in bold up above, and I need to type in the source of the image. If we look down below, we have a helpful hint that tells us this is the path that points to the image. The image has to be on the internet. It has to start with HTTPS. Here, I'll type in an image location. I typed in a JPEG image, but this also supports all of the most common image types. Since all of these other arguments are optional, I'll leave them blank for now and then click on OK. And check that out. We now have a photo of our beautiful oatmeal raisin cookies. And when I hover over it, there you can see a close-up of what these cookies look like. Let's now go back to the function helper to look at what some of those optional arguments are. I'll click this icon once again. And next we have the alt text. This will make your Excel worksheet a little bit more accessible. I'll type in oatmeal raisin cookie. Down below, we also have some sizing, height, and width adjustments. With sizing, by default, it'll fit the image in the cell and maintain the aspect ratio. But you do also have some other options, and I've listed them down below. And same with the height and the width. Now, I don't want to modify any of these, so once again, I'll click on OK. With the oatmeal raisin cookie, I referenced the source directly within the function. But instead of doing that, I can also reference another cell that contains the source. Let's see how that works. Here, I'll select columns F and also D, and then I'll right-click, and here I'll select unhide. And here we see the URL or the source for all of these different images. I'll click into this cell for peanut butter, and let's once again use the image function. I'll type in equals image, open parentheses, and here it wants the source. I'll select this cell right here, which contains the source. Next, I'll close my parentheses and hit enter. And look at that, there we have some delicious looking peanut butter cookies. The great thing here is I'll click into the cell with the peanut butter cookies, and if I go down into the corner, I can drag that formula down, or the function down. And here we see all of those different cookies with beautiful images. That was pretty easy. Now that I have all of my images included in this table, now I can interact with all of this data. So let's say that I want to see the customer rating from the top all the way to the bottom. Here I could click on this and let's sort from largest to smallest. And there you'll see that all of the images also got sorted. And there's that fortune cookie right at the bottom of the list. We're gonna have to prioritize coming up with a new recipe. All right, well, that's a quick look at the new image function. It's really perfect for things like tracking inventory, or maybe building an employee dashboard, or heck, even building games or making a bracket. If you try to follow along, but the function was unavailable to you, there are two requirements. First, you have to be a Microsoft 365 subscriber, and you also have to be part of the Office Insider program. I've included links in the description down below with more information on both of those. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.